Welcome back to Tales of Symphonia.
I'm glowing. Oh, good.
We're almost done with this place.
Oh, good. I can fall asleep again.
Shut up. It's not going to take that long.
You say that.
I said it before, and I'll say it again. My biggest problem with this game is that all of the fact is that a lot of the dungeons look exactly the same.
Yay, murder's
it
back.
Looks like every... Yes, they are.
Murder.
Every single human ranch type area looks exactly the same, and this place is no different. It's not even a human ranch, but it looks exactly like one anyway.
At least we have murder. He's got a shotgun! Look at that shit!
Yeah, but it's not the perfect murder.
That's true. He doesn't have those remote bombs yet.
But anyway, now that we've deactivated all of the doors, we can come back in here and get all the treasure chests we missed.
Woohoo.
Yay, so now I can finally upgrade Colette's armor. It's been like a whole dungeon since she's gotten an upgrade.
It's been like a whole dungeon, question mark.
Also, that sound that's happening is an EX skill of, I think, Genus has it, where every once in a while his max TP goes up. It's kind of interesting, although he doesn't really need it, to be perfectly fair. There's lots of weird kinds of EX skills like that, where walking around on the map does stuff.
Really?
So I think Sheena's got one that makes holy bottles last longer. Or is that somebody else?
I forget.
I know somebody has one that makes holy bottles, the effect of holy bottles last longer. There's an EX skill that makes you be able to run through enemies faster so you don't get into battles as easily. Anyway, but yeah, there's a lot of little ones, and most of them don't really matter too much. Anyway, now that we've got the elevator key, this is the fanciest looking elevator I've seen in this entire game. It kind of makes me think it's going to be like the Shinra elevator in Final Fantasy VII, where you can just see through the glass, and then there's a whole bunch of soldiers that are trying to shoot at you while you go up the elevator. Almost to the exit, not quite.
Yeah, not quite there yet. Sorry.
We're almost there. It may as well be a straight shot there. They just have to throw in this extra scene for some reason. I'm not sure why. You get to loot. There. Stop giving me EX gem level 2s. I have more of those than I know what to do with.
Nevers.
Everyone has the EX level 2 skills by now. You don't need any more. Also, this kind of threw me off because this teleporter looks exactly the same as the first teleporter we were on.
Everything looks the same!
But nope, now we're actually back here again.
That goddamn sword again.
Well, we never took it the first time we were here.
Take it now.
Well, we're going to. That's why we came here.
I said lies and deceit. I don't believe you.
When did Yggdrasil use a sword on you? He punched you in the face a lot, but he never used a sword.
Oh, he must be talking about the time in the Ova where he used it. Oh, wait, they didn't have that scene. Take it to Heimdall and show it to
the Elder. The sword Yggdrasil struck me with, except he didn't even pick it up. It's just been sitting there the whole time.
It's Soul Edge.
It kind of looks like Soul Edge, I'm not going to lie. A waste of specifically effort. Nightmares. Well, more like Nightmares.
That's what Soul Edge is.
His normal sword is just Soul Edge. Sword cannot be touched by they never said that in Soul Calibur 2.
Yeah, Soul Edge is what Nightmare wields. That's my. Josh is like, I made this.
I told Origin that no one can touch that but me. You dick! Yeah, I know. What you gonna do about it?
I mean, Origin made this. I made this.
Like, Origin made it. Yeah, then why can... It's like, Origin made this, then why can you use it? I told him to let me use it. You dick!
I'm just imagining that meme that's like you made it's like Origin made this. Dot dot dot. I made this. Besides, what is splitting the world in two just throw have to do with that? I'm just expecting genius to just throw a rock at him. Only because they were separated into you dick! It's like the cutscene from Sonic Unleashed when you're where Eggman gets has a rock thrown at him. And countless people are ha 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 ha.
Why is there a shortage of mana? Well, what do you think, my fellow kinsman?
Why are you asking Genus? You know Rain's a half elf too, you know?
You're full of shit! Yes. Robots bad. That's why I made robots. Wait.
Magic technology is bad. Looks at Final Fantasy VI.
It's like, no,
oh, wait. Magic technology is bad in that game, too.
It's like this. Magic technology is bad. That's why I made robots that use magic technology. That seems counterproductive.
Hey, but if Magitek is bad, then how come Final Fantasy VI? Oh wait.
I'm just saying, Idrasil, dude. That seems very counterproductive.
He's the villain. Of course, he's gonna be.
I'm slowly trying to create an army of perfect murders to rule the land.
He's the villain. Of course, he's gonna be a hypocrite.
he's making an army of perfect murders. Fuck yeah.
It's like, humans are already fighting each other over a pointless war, so if I build wave after wave of robots, that'll wipe out the humans faster.
What do you mean there's an immortal who does this? No, it's totally original.
That's right. Same way you abandoned the declining world.
I'm just imagining Idrasil dressing up as Dr. Eggman being like, nope, that's totally original.
What you're doing is exactly the same.
Oh, I remember your joke when you got to this part.
I actually forget. What was it?
Yes, it is.
This is when you repeated this line like 4 or 5 times. You repeated this exchange like 4 or 5 times.
If I remember right, I think later I just put in like the Holy Grail. Get on with it! Oh man.
It is the same thing.
You're just a bitch! And who's the god around here? Not you! Fuck.
I mean. Without discrimination. Okay, so I'll get into this now.
What without discrimination?
I like the plot to this game.
It's like discrimination is bad, but at the same time, it's like.
I like the plot to this game, I really do, and I like Yggdrasil as a villain. My only gripe with it is that by the time it gets to this point, the game's already pretty much over.
You know what this reminds me of? The time in Fairly Odd Parents where Timmy wished for everybody to look like gray blobs.
Discrimination will vanish. I mean, that's kind of what this will end up being.
Look at me, I'm wearing pink, I'm different. Hey, who's the kid with the pink shirt? Let's get over there and gray him off!
In terms of future Tales games, the plot doesn't take nearly this long to get started.
Oh man.
The idea of racial discrimination has been there from the start, but they never flat out admitted that it was the focal point of the plot until just now. And we're halfway through disc 2 already. So,
don't you see what's wrong with that? I'm sorry, I have the episode stuck in my head now.
God damn it.
Hi, I can do this now.
He could always do that.
By the way, I kinda want my sister back.
You have no choice.
He wants that too.
Bitch,
but he's using his idea of turning everyone into angels as his excuse to reviving her.
It's like, I'll use this as
so, now
I'll
you use it. Fight Yggdrasil again.
There's not really much of a difference. The only difference is that you get. The only difference is that you kind of have to survive for a little bit. You don't have to win. You just have
to
survive.
You can still die, but I think the battle doesn't last long enough.
No. You have to live. Trust me, I tried.
Oh no, that's right. You have to do a set amount of damage to your Yggdrasil to make
this
go
by. It's like the opening boss fight.
No, the first one he can kill you outright.
No, I was talking about the very first boss of the game.
Oh, right.
It's exactly like that.
Yeah. To be fair, this is one of the harder boss fights.
Not really.
That's not saying much, but considering how he teleports around a lot, it just kind of gets tedious.
Shocking, isn't it?
Poor Colette.
Shut up.
Get up, sweetie.
Stupid trainer!
That's kind of why I find him obnoxious. Is that he has a lot of AoE attacks. AoE arts that can be kind of annoying to deal with.
He just needs that baseball cap and he can be Terry.
Power wave!
No, power dunk!
No, that explosion is totally power wave.
No, it's dunk. It's power dunk. Power dunk!
He doesn't jump and punch you. He doesn't jump up in the air and punch you in the back
of
the head.
He makes the exact same motion.
He's just punching the ground.
Oh,
it's
my
power wave.
Oh, my chest. It's on. Heart attack.
So, Muiji's right. You just have to survive long enough.
Yeah. I like that little scene. It's like, heart attack.
You got hit in the shoulder.
Bitch!
Ah, shit. That's a heart attack. Like, that looks more like a heart attack.
You fucking bitch! Why would you do that? What's wrong with you? Spin slapped her. What's wrong with you?
Bitch, I thought I told you to go away. I didn't Bitch, I didn't ask for your help.
Take your green-haired ass out of here.
Understood.
Negative. Oh, fine.
To save everyone.
Remember that. Next time you'll see me, I'll be playing King Lord, of Fighters. I bet you don't even know what that is. But an illusion. I kinda do actually. Son of a bitch.
There's also a nice little detail that I like about most Tales games that's something that I don't see being done very often in JRPGs, is the villain actually calling your characters by their actual names.
The sword's just sitting right there. We can just go up and take it.
We tried doing that before, and somebody told us we don't have the right to pick it up yet.
Well, eat it.
That was the whole
point.
Yeah,
but he's gone now. We can go ahead and take it.
Oh, good.
Literally nothing is stopping us from picking it up and leaving.
Right. Origin is keeping us from picking it up and leaving.
Bullshit.
They just flat out said that. We've explained that part already. That's the whole point. We've known about the Eternal Sword for a while, and we know we can't use it because Origin says we can't. Origin's an asshole.
I saw that note when I first saw the not more seriousness. When I first saw that cutscene, I thought it was just Yggdrasil being like, "No, that's mine. I can use it. It's mine." I'm just like, "Well, why don't you?" Okay, you just walk away. I can just go and pick it up whenever I feel like. Yoink.
I mean, he does kind of imply that it is his sword, because he was the last one to use it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Well, I can just take your sword. Yoink.
The plot will explain why he can't just pick up the Eternal Sword and fight us with it right
I
now.
Know. Stop it!
I'm just saying that for the viewers.
I'm just saying, you're making me look stupid, but that's not what's happening.
That wasn't my intention.
Let's go to Altessa's place, because we literally have nowhere else to go.
So much so that the game even jump cuts you straight there without even giving you a choice.
You know, we can just stay in Zealous's mansion. I'm pretty sure the king will be chill about it.
We also... I don't know if that's necessarily true. The last time we were there, we kind of pissed off the king, so...
No, we saved the princess. No, we saved the princess. We're good.
Also, Colette's dying again.
Nah, she just fainted.
Poor Colette, she goes through so much shit in this game. Most of which is not deserving for her.
kind of wish it became a homie, human torpedo at this point. Like, still could...
Her arm is also clipping through whatever that thing is.
I have magical clipping powers. Perseus just bored. There's nothing happening.
Mithos is bored. He's just kind of sitting there.
No, did you not see Perseus? He's just sitting in the corner, just staring out into the depths of hell itself. I can't eat. That's why I'm gonna eat something, just to show you that I don't have to eat. I'm gonna punch you.
Well, our best friend is kind of dying right now.
I'm also, shouting to show. I'm shouting to show punctuation.
Mithos, I want to ask you something, but the plot's demanding that I don't say anything about it right now.
Oh, good. I finally had a line.
I've been standing here for 5 minutes.
I said nothing.
It's really hard not to talk for that long.
I've said nothing. What's with you wanting to eat so much? It's almost like he cares, dumb fuck.
Yeah, this is when things with Zelos get a little bit too creepy for no reason.
It's not creepy. It's just awkward. It's not creepy, it's awkward.
Awkward.
That's a better...
Bad choice of words, my mistake.
That's a better word for it. What are you talking about? Of course we're friends. You know we're friends. You know we're good friends and all sorts of friends, right?
Yeah. We've known each other for a month, but yes.
Shit.
Gina, stop that. It's gonna make the next 10 minutes. It's gonna make what's gonna happen in the next 5 minutes a lot harder for me to do. Ah, fuck. Who am I trying to kid?
I like that scene where Lloyd just randomly has narcolepsy.
It's like, oh right. I haven't slept in like 5 hours. Probably should do that.
I haven't slept for days. Meanwhile, Zelos sleeps Indian style. Because he doesn't have a bed.
Okay, so get ready for massive plot dump.
As if it wasn't expected.
My body! I can't move!
To be fair, this game doesn't normally do this very often.
You got a cramp.
Do you want to meet your father?
You again?
Yeah. Hey, maybe.
You again? Didn't Kratos stab you the last...
Oh, shit.
Didn't Kratos stab you the last time you tried to do this?
Oh, shit. Oh, my God. My head is killing... Oh, why did that come in my brain?
I love that look that Lloyd gives, like, that Star Trek teleporting motherfucker.
Okay, is he using the bathroom? Okay. Do not cross. You need to pay a toll. Enemies, aren't they?
It's like, Ewan, so did you really need to teleport out? That seems unnecessary. Shut up. It looked cool, didn't it?
There's a window literally right there. Everyone sleeping soundly.
Drug. Where's my dad?
Drugs. We got drugs over here.
You want drugs? Everything here is drugs. Banana made of drugs. Monkey made of drugs. On market made of drugs.
So it was you. You were the assassin.
You motherfucker. God damn it. You know how long I've been keeping this in?
Kratos, if you value your son's life at all, do as we say.
So you, and you were the one that tried to kill me back in hindsight. In hindsight, you did a really shitty job of it.
I like this. It's like, you value your son's life, you do what you say. It's like, yeah, that's okay. He can take care of himself. Lloyd will die
right here. Oh, right. This is the model that makes you and... Oh, right, this is that weird model that makes Ewan look like he has a mustache, but he doesn't really have one.
What?
Look at the top of his mouth, and next time you get a close-up of his face.
I'm not Ewan. I'm Ewan with a mustache. Totally different.
I guess from your attitude,
oh,
you don't plan on releasing Origins.
Okay, I know. That killed the whole mood. Of, you know, by the way, Kratos is. By the way, Kratos is Lloyd's father. But yeah.
Meanwhile, Dirk's off in the dinner. Is like, he may be your father, but he ain't your daddy.
Oh God.
Changed once you got a family.
So Dirk is Yondu now. Holy
damn
shit!
Straight.
Where's his fin and his whistle missile that kills every and his whistle arrow that kills everything in 10 seconds
in his closet?
That's fucking amazing.
In the closet.
God damn it.
Oh man.
Also Ewan, if you're not the villain, why are you acting like one right now for no reason?
Well, he kind of has to at this point just to make a point. Dick.
But that doesn't make any sense. It literally accomplishes nothing for him to taunt him like this.
He is the vet. Well, there is actually a reason, but we'll get into it once it actually comes up.
Yeah, it's coming up.
Also, Kratos, I'm so sick of this shit. I just want to sleep. And then Clark comes out. What the fuck is happening right now?
And then Ewan's like, I thought I told you to drug them. We did, sir. Obviously not well enough.
I like to imagine Colette has like a completely different personality when she's like the super cranky.
It's not true.
Just comes out, what the fuck is happening right now?
She reverts back to being soulless again for a few seconds.
Like she force pushes these two guys like Yoda does in episode 3 of Star Wars. It's like, alright, fuck this shit.
In hindsight, while this is supposed to be like a big plot reveal of Kratos really? Being Lloyd's dad, it was pretty damn obvious.
You think?
Even if I become an angel, I'm still me.
No shit.
And don't
aww.
Forget.
Hey, no shit.
Kratos saved you.
My back.
Also, Colette, if you're the only one that woke up during all this, where the hell is everybody else waiting for more plot to happen first? Oh, God damn it.
She is distracting everyone telling stories.
Lloyd.
I don't want you to call me dad. You know how old I am? Just hearing you call me dad is awkward.
Do you see me with a 5 o'clock shadow?
Too many people have died. People from Silveron, people from Tethiala. Designs and renegades.
He's just sitting there. It's like, I could really use a back brace right about now.
Victims.
Like, my back is literally shot to shit.
Okay to for
give me something, Lloyd, for God's Lloyd, sake.
Lloyd, it's great and all that you accepted that you want to change the world and all, but I'm kind of dying here.
I need painkillers, for God's sake.
Can you call Rain out and heal me, please?
Do you have any painkillers?
Don't you know how to heal? Yeah, I'm dying.
My back is dead.
Congratulations.
You're one to say corny.
Oh, hi, Tsukasa.
Mithos?
Who?
The voice actor that does Mithos is the same voice actor that plays Tsukasa in Dot Hack Sign.
Oh, I wouldn't have known that. Yeah, see? Yeah, see, you could have done that too if you just followed what I fucking said.
By the way, I was a hidden badass the whole fucking time. Also, fuck you in particular.
Fuck that guy in particular.
You know how long I've been waiting to do that?
Can't you just play along?
Damn it, Yggdrasil! How the hell did you find out?
Bitch, who do you think I am?
What?
Okay, I have a few problems with this.
Bitch.
I have a few problems with this scene, which is kind of ironic because I really like how this scene plays out and how they reveal that Mithos was Yggdrasil the whole time. My problem with it, it came way too late. The game's almost over. We only have like 4 dungeons left. This scene should have happened at the end of Disc
1. I'm going to interrupt you for a second. This scene of Mithos kicking Ewan. That's actually his portrait in Tales of the Rays.
Oh my god! That is amazing!
Yes, it is!
That is amazing!
Yeah. Oh shit!
Maybe. Like, okay, now to be fair, it could just be because I'm spoiled from the later from later games in the series that build their main villains up faster. And this is great. I love that.
I thought my beard could protect. I thought my beard could protect me.
I do like Mithos as a villain. I do. I just think they took way too long to set him up.
Beep 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 beep. I need the song that says "Bee boo boo bop boo boo bop."
Mithos, why are you doing this?
Because humanity sucks, Gene. As I told you this, I literally told you this before.
Now, let me go back to kicking my sandbag.
Hey, Gene, remember when I told you if Lloyd and I got into a fight, who would you side with? This is what I was warning you about. This is your fault for not seeing it coming.
Meanwhile, Kratos is like, I'm just here now.
No, Kratos is like, damn it, I was hoping I had more time now.
They might get a book. Well, I'm not going to be saying anything for this entire scene.
I'm kind of dying here.
Ow, my foot.
Genus, did you not just see that he tried to murder all of us 10 seconds ago? He's clearly evil. Please
lead this to the angels. You're full of shit.
Anyway, in all seriousness, what's your opinion on Mithos' reveal like this? Do you like Mithos as a villain, or do you think they waited too long to reveal him?
kind of overstays its welcome. Also, this is just pointless.
Yeah, it's like, okay, we had like a 5-minute cutscene, so now we have some action.
Yawn.
With the exact same angels that we just fought in like 20 minutes
ago.
They're
not that hard, like, at all.
No, they're not.
Also, Sheena's here now, even though she wasn't in the scene at all.
That's because Sheena was in my active party at the time.
I know. Fun fact that the person who comes out is actually affected by who your highest affinity is. That's not but
really?
Yes.
I thought it was always Colette that comes out
first.
No,
that scene is different depending on who your highest affinity is.
Then who comes in if you have who comes out if Kratos is your highest?
I think the defaults to Colette at that point.
Okay, that explains a lot.
Yeah, but that scene in particular is different depending on who your highest affinity is with. If it's with Sheena or someone, they'll come out instead of Colette.
Huh. Well, that makes me that makes me want to see that scene happen with Genus then, because
yeah, Genus.
If
does,
Genus is there first,
yeah, Genus does come. Genus will come out during that scene if he's the highest.
Okay.
Because that scene will put. That scene does play the same, even if Genus is your highest in the party. But he will come out if he's the highest affinity.
So does he come out of the door twice for his scene when he comes out originally?
No, he just doesn't come out. And
that would be hilarious if they just cut back to him walking out of the house again, just to do that line again.
I left my car keys. Hang on, I left my staff inside the house. But no, I believe he's just not. He's just not inside the house when that scene loads.
That
since he's
sense.
Already on the scene.
I applaud Namco for making like 9 different scenes happen depending on affinity.
Yeah, and they're all voiced too. That's the crazy part.
That's amazing.
It's crazy when you think about it.
This is why I love this game. I've played this game like 10 different times, and I'm still learning things about it that I didn't know about before. This game is so good.
Yeah.
If Lloyd does get into Smash Brothers, which I hope he does, I also hope that they port this game in particular to Switch.
Yes.
Like, port the HD version to Switch.
You'll get Chronicles and you'll like it. You bitch.
Or even just the PC version, because at least then that version will be stable, unlike the PC version at launch, because holy crap, the PC version of this at launch was
You just said you hope they port the PC version because the PC version is trash.
No, the current PC version, not the original PC version.
The PC version as it was supposed to be.
Yeah, the way that it is now, after people complained about it and told Namco, "What the fuck is wrong with you?" When the GameCube version that you released 10 years ago plays better than this version, there's no excuse.
Here's the problem is that the PC version is actually still locked at 30 frames all around.
Because it's more based on the PS2 version, which is dumb, yeah. But what can you do?
And the problem, the biggest issue is that it's not moddable because you always have to be online in order to even play the game, which is stupid.
Yeah. If they do port this to Switch, I do hope
they did that with the GameCube version rather than
the Chronicles version.
They did that with Sonic Mania at first, and then they complained so much, they're like, all right, Sega's eventually was like, you know what? Nope, screw it, we took it out. Sorry, our bad.
Yeah, you did that on purpose, and you got bitched out for it.
Yep. You'd think Sega would learn by now, but apparently not. Hey, is our side character going to be okay?
He'll be fine.
His magnificent beard will live.
He'll be fine. He'll be fine for now, but we need to get a better doctor. Why can't you do it? Because I'm not a doctor.
Dumbass. I was like, is he okay? Yeah, his magnificent beard blocked most of the blow.
God damn it.
There is no... Inside his beard is not beard. There is only another fist.
No, that's Chuck Norris.
Shit, you're right.
and that's only a throwaway Family Guy gag, even though it's one of the better Family Guy jokes.
That's actually a normal Chuck Norris joke.
I know, but they used it on Family Guy, and it's one of the only good cutaway jokes in Family Guy, in my opinion.
What, just because it has Chuck Norris in it?
No, it's just because it actually makes sense.
I remember the death battle between Chuck Norris and Sagata Sanshiro.
Yeah, because that was a thing.
Rumors say they're still fighting to this day.
God damn it. How? They both blew up the world at the same time due to their sheer awesomeness.
Yeah, so? Time's infinite.
We're
time
all
is
dead.
Time is infinite.
God damn it. Anyway, so now that we know Mithos is an asshole, we kind of have to stop him. But first, we have to go to Flanor to get a doctor for Altessa so he doesn't die.
Everyone is racist but me. No, you're totally racist. Fuck.
I mean, we'll get into that in the next part.
Don't worry, I have the perfect idea. Rain, cook something so he'll get poisoned.